My pleasure to present the next presenter, which is Professor Stelios Adamopoulos from the Swedish University of Agricultural Sciences. Oh, surprise, in Sweden. His presentation is titled Liquefaction of Lignocellulosic Biomass and its Applications for Wood Adhesives. Stelios, the floor is yours.
I'm going to talk about different liquefaction technologies, applications, and the focus will be on moderate acid catalyzed liquefaction with some applications for polyurethanes and some novel ideas we had for partial liquefaction and some future work to optimize the moderate acid catalyzed liquefaction and the conclusions. The topic is about liquefaction, and like 3 years ago or something, we wrote a review paper about that wants to get a little bit more info about it. You can read. Actually, liquefaction is one of the thermochemical conversion technologies to convert biomass to fuels or other chemicals. The other three are combustion, gasification, and pyrolysis. The idea behind liquefaction is to turn biomass to oily liquids, but for sure then we have also gas and solid also waste. For that you need an aqueous environment, application of pressure or not, and in most of cases also you need some catalysts. The two categories is the hydrothermal liquefaction and the moderate acid catalyzed. The difference between them is the temperature. In hydrothermal liquefaction, you need higher, up to 400 degrees. Usually no alkaline catalyst, but for moderate acid catalyzed, you need lower temperature, low pressure, or even no. But then, because you have this type of moderate environment, you need a strong acid catalysis. Depending on the solvents, you can get different liquefied also products, biopolyols, polyols, or phenolic compounds, and that also depends on the final use. And the application can vary to foams, films, fuels, asphalt, wood coating systems, even removing lead from water, activated carbon fibers, and our topic on wood adhesives. In our group, we have focused on moderate acid catalyzed their liquefaction. And the reason for that is that you need less energy, and also the costs are not so high. The simple experimental setup, you can see, you need an oil bath, a glass reactor, in our case, 1 liter, a mechanical stirrer, and a condenser. As a material, you can use virgin or any waste. Solvents, polyhydric alcohols and phenols, and as catalyst, strong acids. The liquefaction yield is also very important, but that depends on the biomass type, on the temperature, the time, the type of solvent, the type and the concentration of the catalyst, and most importantly, to biomass to solvent or to weight ratio. How it works? It works by solvolytic their reactions to produce smaller parts, and these parts can further react with each other or with the solvents to form higher molecular also compounds or other compounds also with the solvents. Applications for wood adhesives, depending the solvent, mainly they're the biopolyols because they're abundant in OH groups are used for polyurethanes, for epoxies, and to partially replace formaldehyde also based their adhesives, while the phenolated also biomass and the also the biols from HDL are used in phenol formaldehyde. Advantages, there are quite so many. Availability is one. You can use any type there, for example, of biomass. The thermal properties are quite good. Low formaldehyde you can get, and also VOCs. You can replace synthetic resins, but for sure it's not a completely green technology. We're using a lot of solvents. The composition of liquefied wood, also quite complex, smelly, quite dark, increases the viscosity. Also the curing time is quite high, and it's not nice for the industry, and for sure you compete for the use that of the biomass. Our first work involved analysis of analysis of sawdust. We used this work to produce their different biopolyols for adhesives, their polyurethanes. The idea is to know if any purification step will have there any impact. We use ethylene glycol solvent to wood ratio. We use 3:1. The temperature 150 to up to 190 for their 1.5 hours. And for making this, well, this type of adhesives, we reacted with their associates with MCO to OH also ratios from 0.5 to 1, 1 to 1, 1.5 to 1, and 2 to 1. What we found is that at 100, there at 90 degrees, we had a high yield, and 99, also 0.7. About that, the purification step, high reactivity we got, but as you can see in the slide, this step has no effect in the shear strength. For sure, we need there to do more work, and depending also the type of the polyol, the type of the isocyanate, the MCO to OH, also the ratio, the chain extender, also the catalyst, the reaction temperature, time, and many steps that we need to improve. Here, the novel idea we had was a partial also work, and that was because we used the bark, and the bark takes around about 2 hours therefore the liquefaction and requires also some the other steps. Therefore, and that is because of the high content there of the lignin. So we thought to use a shorter time and take this liquefied bark in order to use it as a furnace material, and maybe it can have some also binding ability. The first step in this work was to know what size of bark we could use. We had therefore groups, fine ones, less than 1 millimeter, middle-sized group, and more than 2 millimeters. The liquefied bark also the wood ratio was 1:4, and then 1:4 and 1:1 with MUF. And what we found is that we can make that with these material boards. And the most important thing is that the mechanical properties were also affected by the type of bark we used. Therefore, the conclusion was to avoid the coarse bark size more than 2 millimeters. The thickness selling of the boards there was not affected by the bark size. That was an additional finding. Then we go on with that work and we make one layer boards. Again, with bark from pine, and we use ethylene glycol and sulfuric acid, 180 degrees for 30 minutes. The partially liquefied bark was 4.7, 9.1, 20%, 33.3%. We made boards also by adding 10% weight there of MUF, and we analyzed all the products with FTAR, TGA, and vapor sorption. What we found in that work is that with FTAR, we have proved that the cleavage of the glycoside links there in the cellulose and the BO4 bonds in the lignin were happened. Another thing we found is that this method was more hydrophilic than bark, and this we can explain by the bonding between the chips and also this type of product. Boards without MUF had no so good also good mechanical properties. In order to achieve meet the requirements with AN standard 312, we had to use at least 20% of this type of product, and 33.3% in order to get the thickness swelling values. We continue the work, and now the idea is to use it to continue the work with core layers and also with surface layers. It seems that for surface layers can work, and additional focus is to know the formaldehyde and also the other emissions. Finally, we work with a optimization of the full there also the process. We are working with time, with temperature, solvents to biomass ratio, solvent type, pretreatment, and so on. And also the conclusions of this work, there is still still a lot to do. For sure, we have to work there with the efficiency, the recycling of the solvent, making them more pure, also the final products, apply liquefaction techniques, new ones, also to recycle the solvents, to understand also more the performance, and also to know the costs of these technologies. And thanks a lot for your attention.
Okay, thank you very much. Any questions for Professor Adamopoulos? Yes, go ahead, please. I think you are muted.
Thank you for the presentation, Sergio. This was a very nice example of your research. Can you briefly indicate in which level of technological readiness this research is, and how long do you think it will need until you can go into at least industrial trials in order to see how good this will be upgraded in industrial production?
Yes, now we are at this step. I can show you this slide. We are for three-layer boards. And to my opinion, for to meet the industrial setup with with this type, it will not be easy. Just because of the curing times, because they are quite long, that is one thing. I don't think that we will meet, but maybe for other type of boards, also can be useful this type of product. So not really to make boards as now they are made made in the industry, but this wet material can be used for. I don't know, maybe other applications, maybe for laminates on tops and so on. It will not be easy.
and based on the let's say on the water performances, the hydrophobicity, I think you can, at least when it will be possible, you can even go into higher moisture stability of the boards, when I see the chemistry right.
Yes. Yes, that is true.
That means trying to at least to compete with phenol-based adhesives.
Yes, I agree with that.
I have a question from the audience. Have you considered mixing with urea formaldehyde or phenol formaldehyde resins?
Yes, we have done that. And actually, this is what we have done with one-layer boards, and now with three-layer boards, we have mixed up to 10% MUF, and then we're using 4.7, 9.1, 20, and 33% in order to see what is happening. And for that, we have seen that to reach a mechanical strength, we need at least 20% well of this material and MUF. If we don't use MUF, then the strength for sure is not so high. But the thickness swelling is quite good when we use 33.3% of this material.
Okay, well, thank you. Last question, maybe. Okay. Thank you very much, Professor Adamopoulos.
Thank you.